Sexy Melody is my newest book. It's the first in a new series. And it's about a group of young teenagers who accidentally form a band. Lots of the kids involved in the band are a little bit on the edge of things, a little bit different, maybe misfits. But they find a fantastic friendship and a real power in the music that they start to create. And Lexi is one of my favorite characters. She's so amazing. She's had a really big loss in her life, but instead of making her bitter or angry, that makes her want to rescue and help other people. So I think it's a book that my readers will really, really love. Seems to be going down really well. Yeah, Jacqueline Wilson is a very popular author in the UK. I admire her work a lot because she is one of the first people who started to write about real life, you know, growing up sorts of stories, which are exactly the kind of stories that I care about. I like to write about emotions and feelings, how young people kind of can learn to sort their own problems out, how friendship and family and kindness can kind of help young people to deal with some of the difficult things that life might throw at them. Jacqueline Wilson does that really well as well. So yeah, I think she's great. It's really exciting for me to be a published author, and I love that my book's popular in Britain. But when I first came to France, I was completely blown away by the reception that my books have here in France. My French readers are absolutely the best, the most amazing, and the most caring kids I have ever come across. They communicate with me every day, you know, by message, by email, by every which way, by letter. They understand the books completely. They really, really care. And when I come to book festivals like Montreux, Salon des Livres, or other smaller book festivals around the country, I cannot believe how much they understand the books. They love them, and they are my absolute favorite readers in the world. It means so much to me. My French readers are amazing. I absolutely love the graphic novels, the comic books of Fille au Chocolat. And I love it because the publisher spoke to me from the very, very beginning. I was allowed to choose the illustrator. I get to see the scripts and see that everything is accurate and the way I would like it, which I think is it's lovely, you know, for me. Also, I think that because those comic books have done very well, they're now asking if there can be more stories for Fille au Chocolat for the comic books. So that is something very exciting. So after this visit to Paris, I will go home, think of more stories for the comic books. So there will be more, another set of stories for Fille au Chocolat in comic book form, which is lovely for me to go back and revisit those characters. I think it's great. Yeah, I think that Fille au Chocolat would make a really good TV series. It might happen in France before it happens anywhere else, which would be absolutely amazing. So I think seeing the stories in comic book form helps to bring it to life for me. I love to see it visually, you know, it's in front of you. I just think it would be amazing. So it could be a movie, it could be TV, but I would love that to happen. It would be amazing. It's so difficult to choose one character from all of the books that, you know, which one would I choose to be for a day? When you're a writer, you get to be all of the characters when you're writing that book. But if I could choose to be one, I think I would probably pick Coco from Coeur Coco, because when I was her age, I was very, very like Coco. I loved animals. I like to change the world kind of ideas. And she has so much fun. So I think I'd like to be Coco, but I also love to be all of the characters, and there will be a million more characters that I want to be too. So lots more books coming along. So hard to choose.